Welcome to the 12th annual PACE Pitch Contest. I started this event 12 years ago when I was still an adjunct at PACE. We were fortunate to get a grant from the J.P. Morgan Chase Foundation to do it, and we've had all kinds of success and all different types of presentations, and it's really been a fun event, and I hope you enjoy it. And it's not designed just for the finalists. It's also meant to be like a living case study in a way for the audience. So you'll get to not only see the teams present and listen to the judges' questions and how they answer them, and it's also a networking opportunity afterwards. So welcome to the PACE community, the students, faculty, staff, administration, and alumni. And a special welcome to the visitors from outside the PACE community. I know we have quite a few of you. I'd like to just start with a couple words of thanks, specifically to the faculty that brought their classes here. We have Professors Naren Bhandari, David Keeney, Michael Crapin, Patrick McGuigan, Xinhua No, and I guess myself as well, because I have two classes here. I'd also like to thank especially Nikhil Kalyankar, the Associate Director of the eLab. Where's Nikhil? Nikhil does a huge amount of work. This is all the work I used to do single-handedly. It's such a luxury to have someone like Nikhil and the rest of the eLab staff. You'll see them in the eLab shirts. We have graduate assistants, student assistants, even some summer interns working here. And of course, I'd like to thank our keynote speaker, David Arabov, who I'm excited to hear about, and our judging panel. We have Brendan Hart, the co-founder and CEO of Prosper, Justin Hendricks, the executive director of the New York City Media Lab, Maria Mull, the senior program manager for the Clinton Global Initiative, and Larry Perlstein, executive vice president of Social Life Management, who was on the panel the second year we did this event back in 2005 when a snowstorm canceled all classes and shut down the university, but we went on. So if I could ask you on your phones not to turn them off, but if you would just silence them because we're videotaping this, you could see quite a few cameras, but if you would especially use them to tweet, you could see on the program PACE is at PACE eLab, and we're using the hashtag PACE Pitch. And if you do want to put in a question, I'll keep an eye on the feed for at PACE eLab, and we could add in some of your questions to both the judges' questions, but also after David's keynote address, he agreed to take a few questions. So just as a quick introduction for myself, I'm a clinical professor of management. I'm the executive director of the Entrepreneurship Lab here at PACE. I'm also a Lubin alumni and was an entrepreneur. I started a couple companies both in the U.S. and overseas and worked in a lot of different areas from starting out on Wall Street to taking off and going sailing for a few years. And I'm active in the New York City entrepreneurial ecosystem with organizations such as the MIT Enterprise Forum, eLab NYC, Disruptive Technologists, and advisor to a few private companies, including several ones started by PACE alumni. And I'd like to think that I still maintain an entrepreneurial mindset as a professor and director here. As a very quick intro to PACE, its entrepreneurship program was actually formally established in 1979, making it one of the earlier ones in the country. It was started as an entrepreneurship concentration in the management department. The pitch contest we started in 2004, and the entrepreneurship lab was started in 2012. It's just across the street at 163 William Street on the third floor. It's a collaborative workspace that's designed to promote multidisciplinary problem solving, experiential learning, and the development of an entrepreneurial mindset. So entrepreneurship's important whatever you go into. It's not just about starting a new business. I pointed out at the last event that I saw an ad in the New York Times for the CIA. They were looking to recruit people, enlisting entrepreneurs specifically. So an entrepreneurial mindset's important whatever field you go into. you could see in the program all the information at pace.edu/elab, and I encourage you to keep an eye. We have all kinds of competitions, not just a pitch contest, but a business plan competition, a mobile app design contest, a hackathon. We have all kinds of speaker events, roundtables, fireside chats, panel discussions. We have networking events. We have endowed scholarships just for entrepreneurship students, actually three of them, from the Chahal Family Foundation, Steve Godoy endowed scholarship fund for entrepreneurship, and the Donald and Ruby Urgot endowed scholarship fund for entrepreneurship. And we've done a lot of other programs. We ran a veterans entrepreneurship boot camp, thanks to a grant from the Blackstone Charitable Foundation. We got a grant to run a Israel entrepreneurship initiative that is real interesting, and the Levine Proof of Concept initiative, where we give grants. We just gave $15,000 to two of the finalists that are here to test their ideas. And we have a number of academic programs in entrepreneurship, a BBA, undergraduate level, a minor in entrepreneurship, and a concentration at the graduate level, a concentration in entrepreneurial studies and an MS in entrepreneurship. So with that, I'd like to move on to introduce our keynote speaker, David Arabov, who's the co-founder, and I could say as of 2 weeks ago, former CEO of Elite Daily. He just retired. I retired first time when I was 29 to go sailing for 7 years, and you're right there. And by the way, it was founded, the company was founded with another Pace alum, Jonathan Francis. So David graduated from Pace University's Lubin School of Business in 2012 with a BBA in Business Administration and Management. He has always had an entrepreneurial spirit that drove him from very early on. While at Pace, he started his first business, Elite Daily, which is now one of the most popular sites among millennials. He recognized a void in the traditional media marketplace and came up with an alternative, a medium that is diverse and a voice of the generation. In doing so, he managed to create a platform that is disrupting media as we know it. A couple key stats on Elite Daily: over 70 million unique visitors a month, over 2.8 million Facebook likes, and over 200,000 Twitter followers. And we'll tell you about this. Last year it was sold to the Globe and Mail, Daily Mail. Sorry, the Daily Mail, a British organization, a private sale. There's been numbers reported in the media that you could look up. But with that, let me introduce a Pace alum that we'd love to have, David Arabov.